Sir, what do you think about, so we came from a meeting from CBCP this morning, mm-hmm. and one of the criticisms was that there are already existing healthcare laws mm-hmm. in the Philippines, and another law, again, would not make a difference. Mm-hmm. So they were saying that maybe it's an implementation, there's already family planning already being done in hospitals, and some kind of form of sex education, and why do we need another law again? And how do you answer to that?
Well, there's a flawed reasoning. You know why? This bill would be a comprehensive measure, nationwide measure on family planning. Presently, family planning as well as productive health policies have been devolved to local government units. And local government units would depend on the idiosyncrasies of the respective local executives. That is why in the city of Manila, during the time of previous mayor, family planning methods, which were considered modern, were completely banned. And because of that, the maternal mortality rate went up in the city of Manila. Unlike in Quezon City, where the approach was different. It was more liberal with respect to the implementation of family planning policies. And as a matter of fact, Quezon City has its own reproductive health code. And these differences are replicated nationwide. So there is no consistency and uniformity in the implementation of policies. That is why there is a need for a national comprehensive policy wherein local government units will have to follow that policy. Another thing is, it might be the policy now, but if it is not institutionalized as a law, then future administration can just jettison or throw away these policies and adopt another policy which is adverse to reproductive health and family planning. And another reason, which is very important, is they say that contraceptives are available in the market. You go to a drugstore or even to a sari-sari store, you might be able to get pills and condoms. But availability does not mean accessibility to those who are marginalized and poor, who cannot afford to buy these contraceptive commodities because their primary concern is food. So government would have to come in and to help these people access the reproductive health products which they think would be consistent with their needs, personal as well as religious beliefs.